smooth enough, accompanied by the usual bubbly. But instead of the submarine going down under, proceedings went a bit downhill after that. One master had trouble finding the vessel. Then it appeared not to want to start. The three young designers, Adam Healy Hutchinson, Tim King and Charles Lunt, who constructed the machine for their A-level design course, called in another master for consultation. Then it was decreed that an engine might make it go. Engine installed, Searcher was on her way. Well, almost. She's designed to search river beds and has attracted some attention from the Thames Valley Police and archaeological groups. The trio are naturally delighted.
We're certainly pushing back some about the frontiers of technology, particularly in the area of towed submersibles, which is what Searcher was originally going to be.
I'd like to see it go into production. I think it's got great potential. We got underwater pipeline maintenance, underwater farming, river search for the police, and archaeology. There is a considerable leisure interest as well, I think. But it could go into production. I think it's ready to go now.
What about just James Bond movies?
That's a bit far-fetched, I think. It's a nice idea.
I understand that you contributed least to this project, is that right?
No, I'm sure my colleagues would probably agree with you, but I did actually design the buoyancy of it, and whether it goes up or down, probably down to me.
And it did go down, eventually. Searcher found her fins in the swimming pool, and apart from a bit of air in one of her ballast tanks, the operation was a success. This is Tina Jenkins at Eton College.